Hi, I'm Roxanne. I've been at MOCA 17 years, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about our Art for Educators workshop. This workshop is geared really towards anybody who wants to teach our work with kids. So we, you know, want to include classroom teachers, artists, parents. It's wonderful when we actually get administrators. I think when administrators see the actual learning that happens during an art lesson or an art class, they actually want that at their school. It's 2 days, it's hands-on. Someone with no experience can come in and learn the basics of art and art teaching. Line, shape, color, texture, pattern, space, how to handle art materials, and also how to reflect and document what you're doing during this workshop, but what you're doing when you go back to your classroom or any kind of learning environment.
I'm participating in this workshop this weekend because it's great to always learn some new skills, some new lesson plans, some new activities to incorporate in the classroom and with students. And no matter how much you think you know, you always can learn more.
I wanted to get ideas so I can go back and implement them in my classroom with my students. And art is one of those subjects that we really don't have time for, so I felt it's important to go ahead and try to use it as often as possible. And having a class to help me with, so I could guide them with other techniques, was crucial for me.
You know, I'm a believer that people have to do things themselves to fully understand how to teach them or do them. So I don't want to be a talking head. I don't want to be the kind of class or workshop where I come in and speak and spew my ideas out. I want people to be able to have a hands-on experience and then react and reflect to that thing they just did. And then we talk about that, like what happened for you? How did that go for you? Let's talk about how people's projects are the same or different. That's, I think, where the real arts learning comes in, is looking at other people's work, getting different perspectives. So that's, I think, one of the big pieces about Art for Educators.
Oh, I loved it. I just love how we jumped in straight away and did all hands-on activities and just direct stuff that I can apply to different lessons that I have. So I like that we didn't have to do too much reading and homework. It was just try this, try that. And I really like that we spent most of our time just doing art projects. That's because I don't feel like I have developed my own personal craft as an artist very well myself, so it's nice to have time to do that.
In terms of this workshop, it's just been great already to just see how other people approach similar ideas and how they walk through the same projects that you might do a different way, and just seeing as many different ways as you can do it allows you to have a varied approach. The way it's been laid out, where you get to actually try the projects and engage with them hands-on, and you have a little bit more time to work with it, you get to learn more about the projects that you might otherwise, you know, just not have that sort of one-on-one connection with.
For so many years, art was cut from schools and programs, and, you know, there's testing and there's standards and there's visual art standards. This isn't something separate. This is something that enhances what we do, and we can put these two things together. So I think by simplifying the lessons for folks and demystifying the art process, teachers get to see, oh, I can do this in my classroom.
A lot of the skills that you need to do art, you apply to anything in life. We talk about persevering and creating and just being able to explain your thinking, synthesizing. It all happens in, you know, in the art, in an art activity.
When I first came to MOCA, someone said to me, relationships are what it's about. The relationships you build with people. And I think when I go into school, a lot of kids don't trust themselves, or adults don't trust themselves, that they can do art and be creative. So I feel like my job is to get them to believe in themselves that they can do this. Successes are that people come away and they're so excited with all this new knowledge that they can actually put to use the very next day. Like, I can do this. This is so simple. And just giving people those tools, the tools to help them develop their teaching practice.
Definitely what has stood out in this workshop for me has just been the documentation and really making it, kind of putting it on the students as part of their job to figure out what it is that they want to add to the documentation board, that it doesn't need to just be me taking pictures and gathering student work, but that they can be adding things to it to show the things that stand out for them.
The goal of the workshop is to make people comfortable teaching art and doing art in whatever type of learning environment that they have to work in.